bless the sun, I bless the skies. I bless your lips, I bless your eyes. My blessing goes with you. In the night time when you sleep, oh, I bless you more than much I keep. As you lie in slumber deep, my blessing goes with you. This is my prayer for you, there for you, ever true. Every day for you and everything you do. And when you come to me and hold me close to you, I bless you and you bless me too. If the world should leave you uninspired, when nothing more of love's desire, my blessing goes with you. When the storms of life are strong, when you're wounded, when you don't belong, when you no longer
I just have to welcome you to my prayer, and anyone who's watching will have seen it is mentioned that my battery has gone low, even though it's all oh, I can turn the light off, don't mind me. Sorry, I thought I was going to have to move the laptop, so hopefully now that's okay. Anyway, listen, welcome to night prayer this evening. I hope you're doing okay and that all your family and friends are keeping okay. As always, we gather to pray for you and to pray for those you love, those who are sick or unwell, those who are sick with the virus, and those who are sick, family who are sick in various parts of the country and in various parts of the world. We also remember those who are expecting, or those who are hurting, or those who are finding it tough at the moment. And I suppose everybody's just, I suppose, watching the news and counting numbers and all that goes with it. And it's not easy. But look, we're here to pray for all that, to bring it all to God. And tonight I'm a little going with something a little different. As we remember your prayers, I'm trying to just see, will it work straight off my laptop? And so it will create a bit of space in the sacristy for a few other things during the day, so I'm not in the way of the others. So that's the hope. So hopefully this will work out. And tonight my prayer is going to focus on teachers. I'm very conscious of our teachers and our families and those who are back to work at the moment. So in our prayer tonight, we think of principals and teachers and staff and SNAs and all those who work in our schools, all those who put so much effort to get our schools back up and running. And it hasn't been easy, but they've done it. So we pray for them. We pray for the students who are back, and we pray for the families. So that's going to be the focus of night prayer. So as always, I just encourage you to breathe. Our breath is what helps us. So I'll just pause that for a second, and I'll leave it take off. So breathe and enjoy the music, and let your breath settle and heal and hold you. To the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. And so tonight, as I say, we give thanks for teachers. We pray for them. We pray they'll be safe. We pray for their students and the families. And I'll show you a little clip from a movie that captures again the influence teachers have in our lives. So hopefully now... Sorry. It's just refusing to. I'll have to. Sorry now about this. I'll have to go at it this way in the hope that it might play.
My apologies for my tardiness.
Now, here we go.
My apologies for my tardiness, and Principal Walters, I'd like you to know, yes, I brought a note from my mother. Mr. Holland had a profound influence on my life, on a lot of lives, I know. And yet I get the feeling that he considers a great part of his own life misspent. Rumor had it he was always working on this symphony of his, and this was going to make him famous. Rich, probably both. But Mr. Holland isn't rich, and he isn't famous, at least not outside of our little town. So it might be easy for him to think himself a failure. And he would be wrong. Because I think he's achieved a success far beyond riches and fame. Look around you. There is not a life in this room that you have not touched. And each one of us is a better person because of you. We are your symphony, Mr. Holland. We are the melodies and the notes of your opus. And we are the music of your life.
So the lady said, "We are your symphony, Mr. Holland. We are the notes and the melodies. We are the music of your life." So she was trying to reassure it, a music teacher, that his influence was great. So I'm just going to share with you a little story as we give thanks tonight for teachers. And you can think of those who taught you. Our first teachers are always our parents. So we give thanks for them and all those who've taught us. So there's a legend. There's a story. It's about a king who decided to set aside a special day to honour his greatest subjects. A large crowd gathered in the courtyard. Four finalists were brought forward, and the king was to select the winner. Now, the first person presented was a philanthropist. So I've obviously used a picture of locally someone like JP. This man, in this legend, had given much of his wealth to the poor and was renowned for his humanitarian efforts. The king was naturally very impressed. The next person was a celebrated physician, a doctor. The king was told of the doctor's incredible service to the sick for many years. The third person was a distinguished judge. The king was told that the judge was a worthy candidate because of his wisdom, his fairness, and his capacity to make brilliant decisions. People were then surprised to see an elderly woman presented as the fourth candidate. For this, now I've used a picture of a primary school teacher I've had, Mrs. Kennedy. I didn't have a picture of Mrs. O'Brien, but again, Mrs. Kennedy and her influence goes on and on. So they were surprised to see this elderly woman. She had a humble manner and a simple dress. She did not have the air of somebody who could be honoured as the greatest subject in the kingdom. Everyone wondered what chance she could have when compared to the other three who had accomplished so much. And yet people were struck by the warmth of her smile and the understanding in her eyes. Now the king, like everybody else, was puzzled by the lady's presence in such great company. And he quietly and discreetly asked his advisor, "Who was this lady?" And the advisor replied, "You see the philanthropist, the doctor, and the judge. Well, this lady here was their teacher." So we don't know how the vote went, but the story acknowledges how this lady had unselfishly given her life to moulding and her children, moulding them with her love and example. And she was a key influencer in producing such great people. So tonight, we give thanks for teachers and those who teach, especially now. The Latin word for education is educare, which means to lead out. So we think of teachers and coaches and all those who lead children out into the world, leading them out into love, into light, into hope, and into laughter. And someone once said that 9/10 of education is encouragement. So tonight we pray for those who encourage us, particularly teachers. And I think it was Einstein once said, "Example isn't another way to teach, it's the only way to teach." So we give thanks for teachers who teach us more by who they are than what they'll ever say. So we bring our prayers to God. So please, God, this will work unlike the last one. No, it didn't. Oh, sorry. No, I don't know why. What's? I'll have to do the same again. I apologize. I don't know what. I have gremlins in the system tonight, but hopefully now this will. No, sorry.
Ooh.
Lord, tonight we pray in thanksgiving for our teachers, those who teach in our schools, all the staff in our schools, all the students, all the principals. Lord, give them the strength and the grace that they need and keep them safe and well. Mentioned, somebody once said 9/10 of education is encouragement. We pray for the teachers and coaches and people in our communities, in our families, in our neighborhood who encourage us. May we all be people who try to encourage others. Someone once said, a good teacher is like a candle. It consumes itself to light the way for others. We pray for the generosity of spirit, Lord, to be generous people who die to ourselves sometimes to give life and light and love to others. Who are sick or unwell, especially remember those sick with the virus, those sick in our hospitals, in our nursing homes. We think of the young people, we remember Dahi as always in our prayers, and baby Kate. There was a young girl, Bavine, who sadly died today. So we think of Bavine and her family. So we remember all those who need prayer. We pray also for those doctors and nurses and carers and therapists and all those who work on the front line as guards and pharmacists and so on. We pray God's blessing on them. And we ask God that he'll let the warmth and strength of his healing love flow through all those who are sick, wherever they are. So we ask those, make those prayers now together as we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. And so we pray our night prayer, especially praying for peace, and for healing, and for calm. We pray for those who've died, we pray for all those who are hurting, and we pray together. Now that the day has come to an end, we thank you, Lord, for family and friends. For all that has happened, both the good and the bad, for the life and the laughter, for the tearful and sad. Looking back on the day, help me to see the ways in which you've walked with me. Thank you, Lord, for the stillness of night. Guide family and friends to morning light. To those who won't make it to greet a new day, may they go gently, angels guiding the way. For those sick or in pain or struggling to cope, draw close to them, Lord, and fill them with hope. And may we sleep soundly with help from above and awaken with gusto to be agents of love. And so our closing prayer tonight is we give thanks for our teachers. And again, you'll see a picture of Mrs. Kennedy appear. But it's a peace call for good. And it's a peace that reminds us there are people in our lives who have changed us for the better. And continue to do so. So as we listen to this piece of music, we pray in thanksgiving for our teachers, for our parents, for all those who taught us what it is to love and what it is to live well, all those who've changed us for the better.
bringing something we must learn, and we are led to those who help us most to grow if we let them, and we help them in return. Well, I don't know if I believe that's true, but I know I'm who I am today. Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes a sun, like a stream that meets a boulder halfway through the wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? Because I knew you.
Give thanks for those teachers, as I say, there's Mrs. Kennedy, and because we know them, we have been changed for good. So we give thanks for all those who change us for the good, and we pray that we will be people who try to change others for the good too. So look, thanks for being with us. We have morning prayer, you're in seminary now, we'll have you in seminary before you know it. We have Mass in the morning at 9:30. So I hope you can put aside your worries and concerns for the night, and with gratitude in your heart for the people who've changed you for the better. We pray good night, sleep well, stay safe, stay well, and God bless.